Well, concerns about crime and a lack of law enforcement leading the Crow tribe to declare a state of emergency last week. Tribal leaders say they will no longer accept lip service when it comes to public safety concerns and want something done about it now. They also say they're working on being more proactive.
It's been a long time coming. We've been crying and crying, requesting for help. But it seems like it falls on deaf ears.
Today, a Bighorn Community College and Crow agency, a meeting to talk about what can be done for some of the problems facing the community. Tribal leaders from the Crow and neighboring Northern Cheyenne Reservation were in attendance, along with law enforcement from Bighorn County, the BIA, the DEA, and the Attorney General's office. The media was not allowed to stay inside for the entire meeting, but I did catch up with tribal leaders afterwards to get their take.
The traffickers, you know, they know how to play the system. You know, a lot of it's jurisdiction law, a lot of it's, you know, back of law enforcement. And so we're hoping that, you know, there's some pressure on all the various folks that have a role in this.
What's a good thing? You know, we really need to curb the drugs and trafficking that goes on within our reservations. We have a major highway that travels in both reservations. Not only that we have lack of law enforcement, so that makes a major is a major point of helping to curb these issues, not only with that, but MMIW or human trafficking, you know.
Where we go from here is we just continue to knock on our senators' doors, and as well as keeping the federal government's trust responsibility in line, because the Crow tribe has a treaty, and the government did say that they would uphold the treaty. And along those lines is safety and welfare of the Crow people.
Well, one thing that did come out of today's meeting is a decision to establish a joint task force between the two tribes and different agencies to continue to work toward addressing some of these problems.